And that was a nice move by the Turk, but the world champion didn't let go of the hammerlock. And you got to hold on, and he is holding on.
Well, the wrestling thing has gotten so sophisticated now. You know, it's really crazy, Steve, but years ago we learned some elementary moves that we thought were pretty sharp. But it's so commonplace today, the kids are doing it in high school, you know.
That's right.
Oh, yes, they're really sophisticated today.
Learning something new every day. And yeah, coming up, ladies and gentlemen, don't forget, a bounty match, Bob Sweetan against Adrian Adonis. Adonis has to pile drive. Sweetan comes up with a leg. Oh, that hurt the knee.
A double leg, yeah, but the knee injuries are so frequent, and so it's so easy to injure a knee. That's what they're shooting for, of course, put them out of action.
The Turk reaches up, grabs a handful of hair, the world's heavyweight champion. Once again, I want to remind all you youngsters out there sitting watching, don't try any of these moves on your friends because they are very dangerous. It's possible you could come up with a lot of broken bones, isn't that right, Lou?
Yes, they certainly shouldn't try it because
goes down. Ali Bey, the Turk, finds himself being slammed by the world's heavyweight champion, Nick-Bockwinkel. Bockwinkel reaches down. Has him up for another slam. Ali Bey, the Turk, down. Here comes Bockwinkel on top. Here's the count. It's one, two, three, and it's all over. It's all over. The world's heavyweight champion, Nick-Bockwinkel, wins another match right here on Southwest Championship Wrestling. Don't go away, because Tully Blanchard and Mike Grimm will be in the ring right after this.
Double leg pick up and goes for it right away. Now, he could have stood there. Instead, he went right with the motion and went down on top of Young. Heenan is off to my left, just on the edge of the ring, watching very intently. In the rope, double drop to Holden. Bockwinkel rolls up on it. Now, I'm looking at the AWA World Heavyweight Wrestling Championship belt. I'm holding it in my hand, and I'll tell you, it's really quite impressive. It is extremely heavy. Maybe that's why they call it heavyweight. I don't know. I'm just being a little light with that. Of course, it has to do with the weight of the wrestlers. But this is what they all want. They want all the marbles. They want, this is the brass ring, baby. This is for the whole thing. And you've got to take a lot of bumps and bruises and aches and pains and still have the ability to take and defeat all of your opponents in order to get to the top of that ladder.
They don't like you, they call you a weasel, I tell you, they can tell you what they want, you know, whatever.
But he, Bobby the Brain Heenan, wherever he goes in those auditoriums, they've got signs. Somebody had a sign 18 feet long. All it said on there was the weasel. And it drove him right out of his gourd. Bockwinkel does. Oh, look at this. Oh. Oh. And Heenan hollers, go, go. On the turnbuckles. Bockwinkel's gonna give him a wrestling lesson there. He just spun him around. In a hole, and by a back body drop, Bockwinkel up quick. The flying drop kick caught him on the shoulders, or on the chest rather. Much exchange of signals between Heenan and Bockwinkel. And here comes that Oriental Sleeper. Heenan says, that's it, baby, put him away. The Oriental Sleeper by Bockwinkel. He brought it back from the Orient. A lot of people say it's a choke. And that's it. Rick Young is put out of business by Nick Bockwinkel using the Oriental Sleeper. And here it comes again. And after the body slam, Bockwinkel grabs him right here. No, turn him around.
People are asking, where did he come from? Because he's such an exceptional athlete, and he can do it all. I mean, you're talking about karate, judo, wrestling. He can do it all. And I'm sure that fans all across this country, Canada, and the United States will see him soon in the arenas.
Nick-Bockwinkel doing a job on his young opponent, doing what he has to do. I don't really think there's much doubt about who's going to win this particular match.
No.
But, you know, you never can tell. We've all seen in every sport that incredible match.
Out. The moment he stepped into that ring, he knew exactly what to do to him. Soften him up a little bit, and pretty soon he'll go for the kill.
Rapone will know that he's been in a fight when he goes home tonight.
Body slam, down he goes. Picks him up again. Gives him another body slam. Two in a row.
In case you were wondering whether Bockwinkel had any strength left.
That threaded pile driver. That's Curtin.
Oh,
man, that's Curtin.
I think that's all she wrote there. Oh, Bockwinkel.
Picked him up. I'm surprised, though. Bockwinkel, a new move like that.
Maybe he's getting meaner as he gets older.
Well, probably figures I'll show this punk.
One, two, and that's and all it. There is. Nick Bockwinkel.
Is on the receiving end of his rap. And now choking. And Bockwinkel just said, describe his head. Well, his head is very red, I'll tell you that. From being choked by the Buddha alongside on the windpipe. On one side and in the bottom ring rope on the other. It's Bockwinkel. Oh, he says new style. All right. Plus the fact that he's gotten on the aggressive right off the rail. Nick Bockwinkel, former world heavyweight champion. Did you hear that? Sound like he shot him. Oh, sound like a bass drum, even sharper crack than that. Look at this, there's a knee alongside the head. And a choke by Nick Bockwinkel, former world champion. The new champion, in case you don't know it by now, regained the title, Vern Gagne. How about that, ladies and gentlemen? Forearm smash across the back of the neck. Rivera fell like he was poleaxed, and vicious knee uppercut. Well, Bockwinkel expending considerable energies, faster than he has in the past in early stages of any match. This is the first one I've had a chance to see him in since he lost that title. Look at this, right on Rivera's upper body from the show across the shoulders and the back. Look at this. All right, the referee just threatened to disqualify Bockwinkel. On the ropes with the choke. Up. Body slam. Fix him up. Fix Rivera up by there. Rivera's body looked just reddened all over. Bockwinkel really hammering away. Well, he says new style. There's really nothing new in the style except it's more intense. And now he's going to choke. Rivera, no, he's going to get up on the second rope. What's he going to do? Oh, and a knee, just a flying knee drop. Boomerangs. Rivera back off that second rope. A backbreaker just tosses him down to the deck. Referees, oh, look out. Here comes a pile driver. This is barred in many states. It should be barred here. And Bockwinkel with the pile driver on Rivera. They should bar it. Here comes another, and he's going to give him another one. Holy smokes. Well, you can break a man's neck. Now what? Oh, he's not going to do it again. Rivera doesn't know whether he's foot or horseback. Going to set him up, and here comes a third pile driver. Oh, come on. This is ridiculous. One, two, three. Nick Bockwinkel really putting it to Angel Rivera. He about drove Rivera's head right through that mat. New style indeed. Bockwinkel really ticked about being a former champion.